the Dragon spacecraft is still on the launch pad. The commercial cargo vehicle, developed under NASA's Commercial Orbital Transportation Services program, did not launch this past Saturday morning, but SpaceX does plan to try again tomorrow morning. We're going to learn the latest on the new plans for the Dragon launch from Mike Horkachuck. He's the NASA project executive for SpaceX, and he joins us this morning by phone from the launch site in Florida. Mike, if I could get you to start with just a brief recap. Tell us what happened there on Saturday morning and that caused the launch of Dragon to be aborted.
Well, we were going through a nominal countdown. Everything was looking really good. And just as the engines were starting to spin up to full power, they aborted on a high pressure in one of the engine chambers. After they saved the vehicle, SpaceX got out to the pad and started doing inspections of that engine area and the engine, and they found that they had a check valve that failed on them. Since then, they've replaced that check valve with a new unit and have tested all the other engines for similar problems and believe that they're good to go.
Are there then additional tests or reviews that have to be completed on the repaired component?
We had a review yesterday. SpaceX held their internal launch readiness review and believe that they've found the root cause of the problem, and they've put into place the replacement part, and they still have all the safety checks that they had on the initial launch attempt to be able to screen for this this problem on any other engines should it somehow manage to manifest itself.
I take it that you're referring to the normal checks that they would do on a normal countdown as they proceed.
That is correct. Okay.
You attended the station mission management team meeting this morning. What was the discussion on the SpaceX situation there?
They were still talking about the overall mission when I broke off. It looked like they understood what the launch problem was. They're working a few final analyses for the berthing operations and the rendezvous and capture, and they're just working that with the international partners as we're speaking now. I believe that's all looking good for launch as well, and we're scheduled to launch on May 22nd at 3:44 Eastern.
That's 3:44 a.m. Eastern.
A.M., right? Correct.
And then the mission operations and the schedule that we saw before, it all pretty much slides to the right by 3 days?
Yeah, there's some very slight differences in the overall trajectory, but there'd be a flyby on the 24th. That activity generally starts early in the morning again, about 3 a.m. Eastern. On May 25th is berthing day. A lot of the rendezvous up to the station starts very early in the morning, about 46 a.m., so before 1 a.m. Eastern, leading up to a berthing about noontime. And then the hatch open is the following day on May 26th.
So that is, it's extending out till Saturday then. This is a demonstration flight for Dragon and for SpaceX. Would you remind us what the official objectives are for this flight?
Well, we've got the objectives from two different flights merged into one. We're giving them the chance to meet all those objectives in this one demo flight. So the first part of it is to do a flyby of station and close a comm link, make sure that they can communicate between the space station and the Dragon spacecraft. And they do that at a slightly longer range from the space station than they would on a normal rendezvous. They're checking out a number of functions that are needed in case we need to ask the vehicle to abort or do a hold in position. They go through those, and then they fly out in front of the space station, up above it, and then phase back behind the space station and come back around the next day to make a final attempt at the rendezvous and docking. And then they come up the R-bar on actual rendezvous day, and there are a number of other demonstrations while they're on the R-bar, and then eventually come in close enough for the robotic arm to grapple with the spacecraft and berth it to the space station.
As you mentioned, that's the objectives really of what was originally planned as two flights, all put together and hoped to be achieved on this one.
Right, so it is a fairly challenging mission, putting all those objectives together. But we've done a lot of work with SpaceX, and our mission ops teams are both coordinating very well, and we believe that we've got a good chance of meeting all those objectives on this flight.
It's not an official objective, but I would guess that aborting the launch after getting that off nominal readings and diagnosing and repairing the issue this quickly are good signs for the SpaceX team, too.
It is. That's one thing that they are very good at, is being able to work through launch aborts and correct those problems and be prepared to go again in a very short period of time. On some of their very early missions, they've been able to turn some of those around in on the order of hours and make another attempt even on the same day.
At this point, then, all of the signs are positive for tomorrow morning's planned launch.
Correct. We are planning a backup day on May 25th. That gets a little bit earlier in the morning at 2:33 Eastern time. But hopefully we'll be going on May 22nd and won't need that backup day.
Mike, thank you for the few minutes. Appreciate the update.
Very good.
Mike Horkachuck is NASA's project executive for SpaceX from the Commercial Orbital Transportation Services Program.